Greetings! In today's astronomy lesson, we are going to get acquainted with two Mars rovers while I'm sorting a puzzle with a picture of each of one. And I begin with the Curiosity rover. Now, this is a car-sized rover developed by the American Space Program, NASA, in their overall program to explore Mars. Now, okay, that looks better now. Okay, let me. Okay, so the Curiosity mission was to land in the crater Gale. This is near one of the poles of Mars, and the crater Gale is believed to be a dry lake with a diameter of 154 kilometers, which is 96 miles. This is the Gale crater. Also, Curiosity is designed to make other explorations like the geology of Mars, Martian climate, and other. Now, Curiosity is launched in 211. Yes, and in today's time, which is 2000, excuse me. Oh, these hundreds and thousands. I have to practice them a lot. So it is launched 2011, and it lands on August 6, 2012. Then it have been a warranty of operation of 2 years, but these 2 years have been extended with more years, then extended more, and now in 2020 this rover opportunity Curiosity is still operational and sending data from Mars. Let's talk about the power source of Curiosity, which is a radioisotope thermoelectrical generator. That is radioisotope thermoelectrical generator. Right? It makes power by decaying radioactive isotopes. So it is not affected a lot by dust storms. Well, it have a dust cleaner somewhere here. If we check the structure of the rover, but this is most of it. Now, this generator have been used also in Viking 1 and Viking 2 Mars landers, but let's see the other rover. This is Opportunity. It is an earlier rover, so it is before Curiosity. And again, I will sort the puzzle. Let's see what was the mission of this rover, this robotic rover. So it landed in Meridiani Planum, which is a plain near the equator. And what is interesting about this plain plane is that there have been found some gray crystals called hematite. Now this is some iron alloy that is found also on Earth in hot springs. So it is strange to have that crystals on Mars too. Now the year of Opportunity launch is 2003, when in 2004 it landed on Mars after its voyage to the planet, and it have been operational till 2018 when the rover stopped. Stopped sending data. Okay, and let's talk about it. Its power source. Now the power source of Opportunity is solar panels, like we can see here. So during good days it collects power, and during dust storms it hibernates. And that is most of it. So today we learned two Mars rovers. Hope it have been interesting and fun.